Eddie, wrestling is your profession, but I also know you have a great deal of interest in wrestling on the youth level, the youngsters, the YMCA, and such as that.
Yes, that's right, Walt. As a matter of fact, there's a big tournament, an amateur tournament, coming up right here in Jacksonville, Saturday afternoon, April 14th.
I believe you told me that your own boy does quite a little wrestling.
Well, yes, he does. In fact, I'm hoping he'll take the state tournament in the 95-pound division.
How old is he?
He's 10 years old.
Well, now, speaking of a 10-year-old wrestler and the professional wrestler such as yourself, there's a considerable amount of difference between the two, more than just the age and the size.
Well, there definitely is, Walt. I've been a wrestler all of my life, you might say. I started in a YMCA when I was very young, and I wrestled as an amateur. That's where most professionals do get their background, although there is a definite difference, as there is going from the amateurs to professional in any sport. In the amateur wrestling, which is strictly supervised by the AAU, boys learn strictly balance, leverage, and coordination between the mind and body, which is something very important, and I think that's the object of most athletic programs.
Well, I know, speaking about being strictly supervised, I know from my own experience in the past that they don't get any better supervision than they do right at the YMCAs in that respect.
Well, that's for sure. And like I have said before, I've made my views very clear. I think that an athletic program should be one designed to help the majority of the boys or students, wherever it may be, in a school, for example. It only takes a very few to make up the football team, and they're usually the big, strong boys. So they just ignore the rest of the students as though they don't exist, so to speak. Well, just as one arguing point, wrestling at least gives every boy a sport to participate in.